was doing.
Just riding my bike. G'day, how are ya?
Hey, everyone!
So, it's October last year and I'm riding home from a benefit. I'm feeling good that I've done something for somebody else. I'm a little bit drunk. I'm a little bit high. And it's a full moon, which means trouble for me because I always make big bad mistakes and poor life decisions on full moons and new moons and waxing gibbous moons and waning gibbous moons. If I fuck up, it's the moon's fault, okay? And I'm directed by the moon because I'm the moon man. And I love that, that's my nickname. And I love referring to myself as the moon man because it's kind of, you know, sexy when a middle-aged man refers to himself in the third person by a nickname. Right, ladies? Don't worry, I have... Don't worry, I haven't had a full erection since 2013. So I'm riding home from a benefit. Now, the benefit was for street sex workers. Street sex workers, like I haven't given enough already. They take and they take and they take. And then all of a sudden, my phone vibrates in my pocket. Now, I shouldn't answer it because I need both hands on the handlebars, but I have got impulse control issues. And I need to see what's happening on that phone, so I pull it out of my pocket, and it's my wife, and it's like, where are you? So Siri, call Lulu. Hi, booby. Hi, Lulu. How are you? Where are you? I'm just riding home now. I'm going up High Street. Why don't you come around to Tiff and Steve's? There's shenanigans and beer. You can interpret that any way you want to. I said, no, I shouldn't. She goes, come on. So I said, all right, I'm turning into Chapel Street now. I should really get off the phone because I'm on my bike. And then I hit a tram line and bang, I'm off the bike. There's the scar on my elbow. There was a lot of blood. And that was, I could even see a little bit of bone. No, I couldn't, but I protected my phone, okay? You can take my elbow, but you're not taking my phone. I might need it around about midnight to start a Twitter spat with a reviewer from Adelaide. Fuck you. You're not getting my phone! But I'm lying on the tram tracks and I'm outside the Pran Town Hall. Now, there's a hobo on the bench outside the Pran Town Hall. When I say hobo, you immediately think homeless man, someone struggling with mental health issues, someone coming to terms with their drug or alcohol addiction. I say hobo, and it's the umbrella under which all of those terms can sit happily, okay? Because hobo's a good word, hobo, two syllables. And when I say hobo, you see a Dunlop volley with a hole in it and a dirty toe sticking out, reaching for the sunlight. And he stands up and he is indignant. He goes, oh, that's no good! And he comes over. And he reiterates to the ether or God as if to say, you fucked with me, now leave him alone. That's no good! And he picks me up and he goes, you're all right, champ. Champ! When another man calls you champ, you're 6 years old again. Adopt me, take me with you. Let me start all over again. I've made too many mistakes. It's like when you go into a fish and chip shop and the guy behind the counter says, do you want sauce on the dim sims, Tiger? Tiger? So he picks me up, he goes, you're all right, champ, and he puts me on the bike and then he pushes me off like an Olympic coach. He goes, go on! And off I go to join Lulu at Tiff and Steve's for shenanigans and beer. And I bathe my arm in Dettol and we all have a big laugh about what a 13-year-old I am mentally and responsibly. I laugh at the tears in my pants and bandage me up and I go home drunker and higher than I previously was.